Hi, my name is Vaibhav Bhardwaj, and I'm Senior DynamoDB Specialist Solutions Architect at Amazon Web Services. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use AWS Backup to migrate your DynamoDB tables between AWS accounts. I have recorded a detailed video and published it within DynamoDB Nuggets playlist that outlines four different methods that can help you to migrate your DynamoDB tables between AWS account. I would strongly recommend you to watch that video first and then watch this demo. In this demo, I have used three AWS accounts. The first one being AWS management account that will be used to manage AWS accounts within AWS organization. The second account is source account that hosts your DynamoDB table that is supposed to be migrated to some other account. And that's the third account, the destination account, where we'll be migrating our DynamoDB table. So I'll see you in the demo. Let's jump in AWS console in AWS management account for organizations. In this account, search for AWS backups. In AWS Backup Console, click on Settings. Now, in Service Opt-in, make sure that you have enabled DynamoDB. There is a new feature called Advanced Features for Amazon DynamoDB Backups. It is enabled by default. Make sure it is enabled in your account as well. Now, go to Cross Account Management Settings. And make sure that these three options for backup policies, cross-account monitoring, and cross-account backup are enabled. By default, they are disabled, and you would need to click on the buttons here to enable them. Once they are turned on, go to DynamoDB console in source account and under backups, turn on the backup setting named Advanced Features with AWS Backup, which allow options for cross-region and cross-account copy for backups. Once all these features are enabled in the management and source account, we will go to destination account. In destination account, open Key Management Service and click on Create a Key. We will create a symmetric customer managed key that will be used to encrypt and decrypt AWS backups. Give a name to this KMS key. Allow the user from source account to access this KMS key. Review the key policy that allows root user of the source account to use this customer managed KMS key and click on Finish. Now, our customer managed KMS key is ready that allows user from source account to access this key. Now, we'll use this KMS key to create a backup vault in destination account. In destination account, go to AWS Backup in console and create a backup vault. Give a name to this backup vault and choose the same KMS key we have just created in destination account and shared with source account. Once the backup vault is created, we will allow access to this backup vault from all accounts within the AWS organization it belongs to. This is how the policy looks like for an AWS backup vault that allows access from all accounts within the AWS organization it belongs to. Review this policy and click on Save Policy. Now, let's go to Source Account and create Customer Managed KMS Key. Make sure this KMS key can be used by destination account. This can be achieved by providing the AWS account number of destination account here. Verify the policy and click on Finish. As we did in destination account, we will use this KMS key to create a backup vault in source account. In source account, go to AWS Backup in Console and create a backup vault. Give a name to this backup vault and choose the same KMS key we have just created in source account and shared with destination account. Once the backup vault is created, we will allow access to this backup vault from all accounts within the AWS organization it belongs to. Review the policy and click on Save Policy. Let's create a backup plan in source account now. We will build a new plan from scratch. Give a name to your backup plan. We will define a backup rule that will create the backup in the backup vault we have created in source account just now. Select that backup vault here. You can choose the frequency of this backup plan. I am selecting it as hourly here. Now, we will define the backup window. This means we will specify the time of the day when the backup will start. You can also choose the time zone, else the time zone will default to your local time. The backup job will not run immediately. You will have to choose the period of the time in which the backup plan starts. The minimum value is 1 hour. It defines the period of time in which a backup needs to start. Doing this helps ensure that your backup starts during the window. We will also choose the value in complete within. It defines the period of time during which your backup must complete. If the data transfer for backing up your resources does not complete during this period of time, AWS Backup will display the status as expired. Pay attention to this part now. We will choose a region to copy this backup, and at the same time we will select the option to copy the backup to another account's backup vault. Enter the ARN name of the destination backup vault we had created earlier. Also, allow the destination account to copy data back into source vault. Once this is done, click on Create Plan. Now, we will assign the resources that should be backed up using this backup plan. Under Resource Selection, we will select Specific Resource Types, then select DynamoDB. Then we will select the DynamoDB table that needs to be migrated from source account. Click on Assign Resources. Now we have to wait for the backup job to get triggered. It can take some time to get triggered based on the start time and backup window. I have fast forwarded the video and I can see that every hour the backup job was launched. It created a backup of the source table and has successfully stored it in backup vault of the source account. You can click on the job ID to see its details. To check if the backup job has also copied the data to backup vault in destination account, click on Copy Jobs. Here, you can see all the backup jobs that copied the data between backup vaults across AWS accounts. We can see that many such jobs have completed and have successfully copied the data in destination backup vault. You can actually monitor all these jobs from the management account of AWS organizations. Head to the management account of AWS organizations and in AWS Backup Console, under My Organizations, click on Cross Account Monitoring. Here, you can see all the backup jobs and copy jobs across AWS accounts. Now, let's go to destination account and see the data copied in backup vault. Click on the recovery point ID of the backup copied. We can see this backup has come from source account. To restore a DynamoDB table from this backup, simply click on Restore button. Enter the table name for a new destination table and click on Restore Backup. Depending on how big is the backup, your restore job will finish in some time. I'm fast forwarding this video and I can see that our restore job has finished. Let's go to DynamoDB console and check if the restore table has same data as source table. Here, we can see that the restore table has two items. Let's go in source account and check the table there. We can see that the source table also has two items. This confirms that we are able to migrate our DynamoDB table between AWS accounts using AWS Backup. Thanks for watching the demo. I hope you found it useful. Do let us know in the comment section about what are the different topics on which you would like to see upcoming DynamoDB Nuggets videos. Thank you.